At the American Academy of Neurology, we presented a course discussing two disorders that are distinct from multiple sclerosis, specifically myelin oligodendrocyte glycoprotein-associated disease, or MOGAD, and neuromyelitis optica spectrum disorder, NMOSD, which largely is linked to antibodies against aquaporin-4. These disorders each are distinct from each other, as well as having very distinct features from pediatric multiple sclerosis. Importantly, the availability now of a biomarker, the antibody detection for MOG or aquaporin-4 in the case of neuromyelitis optica, allow us to more reliably identify children presenting with each of these disorders, and very importantly, to manage them, because the treatments being proposed for these disorders have some important distinctions. For example, in multiple sclerosis, the previously used first-line therapies, interferon and glatiramer acetate, at least in case series related data, do not appear to be effective in children with MOGAD or NMOSD. Increasingly, pediatric multiple sclerosis patients are being offered treatments with more effective therapies, such as fingolimod, an anti-CD20 infusion-based treatment. In the case of MOG-related disorders, there are no current clinical trials, but in a recently published international consensus indicated that for children with MOGAD, a few key points. Number one, about 70% of the time, MOG-related demyelination in children is a single event, and it may not be a chronic relapsing disease. That's completely different than relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis or neuromyelitis optica spectrum disorder, both of which are both chronic and relapsing throughout the child's history. So in children with a single MOG-related demyelinating event, we manage the initial attack with corticosteroids, sometimes with plasma exchange or immune globulin, but we don't need to put them on chronic therapy. Those children that declare themselves as having relapsing disease, in that case, the current consensus treatments for relapsing MOG disease in children are either anti-CD20 therapies, such as rituximab, or monthly immune globulin. Others have used mycophenolate mofetil, and somewhat less commonly, azathioprine. Which is best is unknown. There are no comparative head-to-head trials at this point, and this is an area of active need. And several planned studies are currently moving forward. In the case of neuromyelitis optica spectrum disorder, I'll just finish by saying that there have been several very important trials in adult NMO-related disease using new treatments, both directed either at the C5B9 complement cascade, directed against IL-6, which is a cytokine, or anti-CD20 therapies. And certainly the recent studies have shown high efficacy, particularly with the eculizumab, which is an anti-C5B9 targeted therapy, and with therapies that are directed against IL-6, which is exciting because neuromyelitis optica is a very serious disease, in particular with poor recovery sometimes from relapses in both children and adults.